Hey, Uncle Mark in the mothership, three string, cigar box guitar. This is White Room. This is Cream. Cream, White Room, great tune, but what do we got going on? G, D, G, 42, 34, 24. Those are my gauges. They're electric wound guitar strings. I am in open G tuning. As always, all of my lessons are in open G. At the nut here, we have G. G sharp A at the second fret, and you're going to need this chord. This is an A. You're going to need the B flat as well. B, C, you're going to need this C. C sharp D. That's the main body of chords, but that little intro, which you're going to do twice in this song. D sharp E F, you're going to need the F, and G at the 12th fret. So those are the shapes. Second fret. So if you're going to do this song with one finger, you need open, 2nd fret, 3rd fret, 5th fret, 7th fret, 10th fret, and 12th. The key of this song is D, and D can be found here. And it's easiest just to remember G, G sharp, A, B flat, B, C, C sharp, and D. There's 7. Also, there's a dot there. So if you start using these dots, right, you know it's number 4. Okay? Or this is the 3rd dot. I'm sorry, that's 4th. So, that's the key of this song. So the intro is on the 12th fret. It's going to go from 12 to 10 to 7 to 5 one time. Then it's going to go 12 to 10, 7 to 5, and then to 2 the second time. So, time through, and that's just with a jangle jangle. I tend to like a that better with the big boom. And then you go to the A, and if you have the stretch, you can make this A minor. But you don't need to. I don't know if you know this, but minors don't matter. On a 3-string guitar, you don't have the notes to make it. A minor chord takes 4 individual notes, and you really only have 2. You have a D and a G twice. So, go to there. So, G, F, D, C, second time, G, F, D, C, A, or A minor, then the song starts in D. Or this finger. If you have a full use of your fingers, it's best to start modulating. So D, C, open, B flat, C, D, like so. That's the most efficient way. But hey, we can do this with one finger. In the D, D, C, G, G, B flat, C, D, D. Fret open, 3, 5, 7. Okay, so a lot of this movement. Lots of beginners have trouble going from. That is something you're going to need to practice. If you like classic rock and you want to play classic rock efficiently, sweetly, nice, this is something you're going to have to learn, is to move efficiently 2 frets at a time. So this is called a whole tone. So you're moving a whole tone from B flat to C, a whole tone from C to D. Whole tone, whole tone. Okay? F to G would be a whole tone. All right? And that means 2 frets. So a whole tone is 2 semitones. And a semitone is 1 fret. So I moved a semitone. I moved another semitone. Those together, 2 frets, is a whole tone. So that just gives you some jargon that you really don't need, but it's kind of cool. So whole tone, whole tone. The most efficient way to do that would be C, or B flat, C, and then hop the 3rd finger. Because from 3 you can go to C, open. And if you notice, my thumb is down here. I really have to do a lot of pressure to get that note on that 3rd finger, but you can also use a helper finger here. And you can also use your pinky. Lots of guys do it, and I do too. My pinky. I'm using my 3rd finger so you can actually see my hand, but I'll naturally gravitate to using my pinky and this 3rd finger helper. So it would look like. Like so, and that's how I would do that section. So this song has an intro and a lyric section, then a little chorusy section, and that's a C. Then I'll wait in this place. Open G, B flat, A, C, G, B flat, A, slide up to D. So I'll wait in the queue. That's how that navigates. So you have the little intro, the 12, 10, D, C, so the G, F, D, C, and then you do the G, F, D, C, A, start the thing, and that is a D, C, open G, B flat, C, D. Then you have the chorus-y chorus thing, the C, open G, B flat, A. Then after you do one of those, you do another, then you go back and do that intro. So that intro happens in the middle of the song. It's kind of like a bridge again. So that's how the song works in its navigation. If you feel really confident and you can play with it and you want to fool around with soloing, you can start from C to D. Those are 2 notes you can start with, so you'd be going. feeling more comfortable, take these two notes and move them to the D string. So if those two notes are C and D, I want to move them to the D string. Where's the C? D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A, B flat, B, and C. So I want to play these two notes up here. Now I'm up here as opposed to here. And that's 10, 12. And you know, these two notes work well. That little blues box works really nicely for D, which is here. C, D, F, and G. And we know these F, G, C, and D's work because we do the G, F, D, and C in the intro. So again, so those notes all work, and when I'm bending almost to there, so between these two notes. I'm almost there. So that's what I do when I like to solo in this thing. If you see my companion video, you'll see me solo around. The link is down in the show notes, but definitely look at the companion video if you wanna learn to navigate a little bit of how this thing works. It's really fun and just starts up here on the D string, 10, 12, 10, 12, bend. Anytime you're in the key, whatever the key is, you want to start your solo on that note. Go start low, go high, go back low again. So I'm starting on D, going high, going low again, lower, go. So that's how to navigate a solo. Thank you so much for everything you do for me. I really, really appreciate it. We got t-shirts. Yeah, the freak is right there. Yeah, we got t-shirts. We got a new website. I am giving one-on-one coaching. So if you want to sign up, I have an availability calendar. It says one-on-one coaching. And that would be just me and you personally on Zoom. And it works very well, and I want to thank you so much for all the people that have signed up for lessons. Really do appreciate it. We're a 100% donation channel. That way I keep all the riffraff out, the stupid commercials and all the things. At least I try to keep them out. YouTube keeps putting them up, and I keep taking them down. So that's how that goes. But a buck a show is all we ask, and we have donation links below. We have a PayPal and we have a Square. Check those out. They're both safe and secure. Thank you so much for all your generous support. You all have really, really made everything happen here. You've made the website happen. You've made the mothership happen. You make it so I can do this. You make the heat in here happen. You make the electricity happen. So thank you so much for everything you do. Like I said, a buck a show is all we ask. And check out the t-shirt link. And I'm going to show you the settings I use on my cube here. I'm on the battery power, so I'm not even plugged in. And here we go. So I am on that Brit combo. My gain is straight up. Okay, my tone is not quite dimed. It's about 3/4. And as you see, I've got reverb to that fourth notch. I really like having some reverb. So this gives you a look at my cube. So thank you so much for everything you do for me, really. I cannot thank you enough for all the things you do for me. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Do check out my new website. The link is down in the show notes as well. And definitely see the one-on-one coaching. If you're having any trouble, I can steer you in the right direction. So and we'll have fun at the same time, because that's what this is all about, is fun. So we'll see you. Cheers.